think it's really important to remember that healthy children have been hospitalized or have died from COVID. 30% of our hospitalizations for children have been in healthy children. And I think it's important to also remember that that healthy child is sitting next to an unhealthy child in school. And it's almost our community prerogative to make sure that we are protecting our fellow community members and our fellow students in that school or classroom.
Welcome to 20 Minute Health Talk. I'm your host, Rob Hoyle, and today we're talking about vaccines for the under 12 crowd. 5 to 11-year-olds have just been given emergency use authorization for the vaccine. We have a panel of pediatric experts who also have loved ones getting vaccinated in the 5 to 11 age group. We have Dr. Sophia Jan, Chief of General Pediatrics, Dr. Lorry Rubin, who is the Director of Pediatric Infectious Disease at Cohen Children's Medical Center. And we have Dr. Mundeep Kainth, who is a doctor in pediatric infectious diseases. Dr. Jan and Dr. Kainth, last time I saw you was at Cohen Children's Medical Center, where 8 children ages 5 to 11 got their COVID vaccine. And Dr. Kainth, your child was one of them.
Well, it was really just a moment of relief washing over me as I saw my child being vaccinated. It was sort of a door that's being opened, I think, for all parents here who have been waiting since the first adult was vaccinated. And it was such an amazing moment to actually have Sandra Lindsay there. I got to take a little photo op with my son and her at that time. And so it was a great doctor moment. It was a great mom moment.
And not only are you talking the talk, but you're walking the walk. You had your children vaccinated. Dr. Jan, you said it's really important for you to be part of this movement to reassure parents and people about how safe the vaccine is.
Absolutely. So my kids are 11, 9, and 6. They're in that full spectrum in this age range. And, you know, for my own children, we haven't really been able to see my in-laws, their grandparents, much because my husband's parents are still very, very nervous about having kids who are not immunized come visit them, particularly because they're in school. And so it's been really, really hard for these last 2 years. And we've been very strict about not having the kids go on play dates, and we certainly haven't traveled by plane at all. And so, you know, it's one step closer to getting my kids into a more normal pre-pandemic life. But again, as a physician, you know, I take care of lots of kids who are both healthy and as well as kids who have lots of chronic conditions. And I've, just like Dr. Kainth said, like I've seen lots of kids get quite sick. Many kids do well, even after getting COVID, but there is a proportion of kids that get really, really sick with significant long-term complications. And I certainly would want to avoid that as much as possible. And I want to sort of have honest conversations with parents who are still nervous about it so that they can feel, get all of their questions answered and feel as reassured as they can be before getting the vaccine.
Yeah. And, you know, when you mentioned a thing that's very common that I've heard from a lot of parents and children is that the children miss their grandparents. They want to see their grandparents. And Dr. Rubin, you have a beautiful little granddaughter. How excited are you that now she is also vaccinated?
Yes, I'm very, very pleased about that. And it'll just make sort of family gatherings that much safer and that much easier, both sort of physically in terms of the potential risk, as well as psychologically, being less worried about transmission within that extended family.
So if you have a healthy child, why should you get the vaccine?
I think it's really important to remember that healthy children have been hospitalized or have died from COVID. 30% of our hospitalizations for children have been in healthy children. And I think it's important to also remember that that healthy child is sitting next to an unhealthy child in school. And it's almost our community prerogative to make sure that we are protecting our fellow community members and our fellow students in that school or classroom. And so there are many, many reasons why your healthy child gets other vaccines. Your healthy child gets the polio vaccine, gets the MMR vaccine. And those are not nearly as prevalent as COVID is now. And we do that to prevent illness, to prevent complications, prevent hospitalizations, and prevent death.
Yeah, and we were just talking before about, you know, that Dr. Jan has said she's seen a lot of sick kids with COVID. More than 8,300 kids ages 5 to 11 have been hospitalized, and 791 children have died from COVID-19, including 172 children in that 5 to 11 age group. Are there any negative side effects? Are there any severe side effects from the vaccine?
Yeah, the studies that have been done with the vaccine show that it's been extremely well tolerated, and no sort of serious adverse effects have been recognized. In fact, the vaccine in the 5 to 11 age group has a little bit less side effects, like the possible occurrence of fever and so forth, than in the 16 to 25 age group to which it was compared. So the vaccine is very well tolerated. It's certainly possible, like any vaccine, that the child may get a sore arm or redness of the arm after the vaccination. But in terms of longer term or more serious adverse effects, we've just not seen that. The vaccine is one third the dose that's given to adolescents and adults. But that smaller dose was shown to not only induce the same amount of protective neutralizing antibodies, but also was highly effective, was over 90% effective in this group of children that participated in the studies.
Yeah. So Dr. Jan and Dr. Kainth, kids usually do not like to get shots. So how do you prepare your children to say, hey, let's get this shot? It's important.
Well, I think it depends on the developmental age of that child. What I said to my 6-year-old is a little bit different than what I said to my 11-year-old. For my 11-year-old, I could sort of explain to her sort of the overall rationale about why vaccines in general are important. And she was looking forward to the vaccine anyway, even though she was nervous about the pain that might come from it. But she was fine with it. I think for my younger kids, sometimes explaining the rationale helps, for some kids that works. For others, you just have to distract them with something else and just, tell them to bring their favorite toy, tell them to let them use your iPad something to distract them. I think there's lots of parents are really good about sort of figuring out ways to distract their kids, particularly the younger kids, around this vaccine. But it does depend a little bit on the developmental age of that child.
Sure. And Dr. Kainth, what did you tell your children?
So we enrolled our youngest in the Pfizer trial, and I can't tell you, how many pokes and prods he had to get for blood draws, for vaccine doses. And what was the most important thing for them was that they could, once they found out they'd be vaccinated, they could do all these things that they normally couldn't do. Go to arcades, visit grandma, grandpa, as we mentioned before, who actually live across the border in Canada. And to resume normal activities, like just go to birthday parties, because, all of these things for some kids are really important. And even my 6-year-old understood that. And that's why he was willing to be a part of the trial. And I cannot tell you the moment I put the trial folks on speakerphone. And I said to Ishan, we're going to find out if you got placebo or vaccine. And he's like, I got it. Did I get it? I was like, well, listen. And so the woman said, happy to tell you, you got your vaccine. And he was like literally jumping for joy, not because he was going to have to get 2 more shots, but because, because if he had gone placebo, he would have to get 2 more shots. Right. But because he knew that he was protected and he knew we could start doing things again as a family and in our community. And that was really meaningful.
That's awesome. And was Ishan also have a sense of pride that he is part of this solution? He's part of the, this pandemic to make it this pandemic an endemic?
Right. So not only is my older son a superhero, I've been calling him a superhero too, because he had been part of sort of history. And we really are have been waiting on the edge of our seat for so long to get this data out and to get this vaccine out and to find more research when there's already a placebo-controlled, double-blinded trial that already has data. There's really no better gold standard than that type of trial for data for vaccines. And I think waiting makes us have more of a risk for, as Dr. Rubin pointed out earlier, variants to emerge, a new wave to happen with